Hello students, welcome back to English literature class. Today I'll be continuing with the story Old Man at the Bridge. Hope you remember what I was doing in my previous video. At the beginning of the story, we were introduced to the picture of a war zone, how people in trucks and carts flee from their native towns to safer zones. We are introduced to the main character, two main characters, that is the old man and the soldier. The story is being told through the soldier's eyes. We know that the old man had walked 12 kilometers and hence was exhausted and couldn't move further. The soldier, being very kind and compassionate, tries hard to coax the old man, but in vain. Now we shall see what happens to the old man in the next part of the story. Moving on to the next para on page 50. He looked at me very blankly and tiredly, then said, having to share his worry with someone, "The cat will be all right, I am sure. There's no need to be unquiet about the cat. But the others, now, what do you think about the others? Why, they'll probably come through it all right." "You think so? Why not?" I said, watching the far end where now there were no carts. Now the old man looked at me. The old man looked at me, the soldier, very blankly, without any expressions, and tiredly. Of course, now he is totally exhausted. Naturally, he is tired. So he shares his worry regarding his animals. So he tells that the cat will be all right. That is, cat can survive. It can be independently. It can look after itself. But he is worried about the other animals. There is no need to be unquiet about the cat. Unquiet here meaning he is not worried and anxious about the cat, but the others. He is worried only about the other animals. Why? They will probably come through it all right. So the soldier says, they will come through it all right. Come through it meaning they will be successful in surviving. For example, we say she's come through the operation very well. Come through means here the operation is successful. So the soldier says that the animals will survive without any interference, or without the old man, definitely they will be surviving. So why not, I said, watching the far end where now there were no cuts. So the soldier, once again, he is talking to the old man as well as performing his duty, and he also sees that everybody had left the place. But the next few lines, "But what will they do under the artillery when I was told to leave because of the artillery? Did you leave the dog cage unlocked?" I asked. "Yes." "Then they will fly." "Yes, certainly they will fly." "But the others?" "It's better not to think about the others," he said. "If you are rested, I would go," I urged. "Get up and try to walk now." "Thank you," he said, and got to his feet, swayed from side to side, and then sat down backwards in the dust. "I was taking care of animals," he said dully, "but no longer to me. I was only taking care of animals." Now here the soldier once again encourages the old man and urges him to get up and move. And he also, the old man is worried, how will his animals survive the artillery when he is all alone here? He is far away from those animals. So the soldier questions the old man, asking, "Did you leave the dog cage unlocked?" So he says, "Yes. Oh, when it is open, definitely all the pigeons will fly away. You need not worry." So he is worried only about the other animals. So the soldier once again encourages, saying, "If you are rested, I would go." "I would go," he has to perform his duty. So he says, "I'll go. Before that, get up and try to walk now." So once again he encourages the old man to get up, to move, that is to make one final attempt. So when he said this, the old man tried to get up, got up to his feet, swayed from side to side means he couldn't balance himself, probably because he was exhausted and very tired, and he collapses down in the dust. "I was taking care of animals," he said dully. So he continues to express his concern over the fate of the animals he had left behind. His thoughts are obsessed about the safety of his animals. So you can see, children, a warlike situation doesn't spare not even an old man. He is displaced. Displaced, he is uprooted from his native town, that is San Carlos. He is disoriented. Disoriented meaning he couldn't come to terms within himself and is all alone. So moving on to the last part of the story. There was nothing to do about him. It was Easter Sunday and the fascists were advancing toward the Ebro. It was a grey, overcast day with a low ceiling, so their planes were not up. That and the fact that cats know how to look after themselves was all the good luck that old man would ever have. Now, when confronted with such a dilemma where danger is imminent and escape is difficult, he talks, that is, the old man talks only about his animals. The soldier was also helpless and fails to motivate the old man to move. Now, it was Easter Sunday. Easter Sunday, what is the significance of Easter Sunday? It is a day of celebration for the Christians as Jesus Christ, the Savior, rose from the dead on the third day after he was crucified and was reborn on that Easter day. But for this old man, it is his inevitable death and destruction. This is very ironical. Easter is viewed as a welcome time of rebirth, renewal, and possible change. But for the old man, it is farewell and very disappointing on this Easter Sunday. Now, it was a grey, overcast day with a low ceiling, meaning the sky was covered with dark, thick clouds, and hence the enemy planes were not seen on that day. And the old man's death is postponed only for some time. But we all know that once the fascist enemy troop attack, definitely the old man will die. That's why the soldier tried various means to coax the old man to move from that place, but he was in vain. The old man's good luck was that cats would look after themselves and his enemy planes were not up in the sky due to the overcast weather. Now look at the words in the story, that is, like grey, dusty face, black, which suggests sad and gloomy atmosphere. Now, hope you have understood the story, all of you. Children, did you see how the old man becomes a symbol of the countless civilian victims of war? We see how the old man is displaced, uprooted from his hometown, that is San Carlos. How he becomes disoriented, that is how war affected his mind and living. He couldn't come to terms within himself as he was forced to leave his place, foodless and homeless, all alone, faces the inevitability of death. Now, let us see the title. Let us see how appropriate the title is. The title, The Old Man at the Bridge. As the title Old Man at the Bridge suggests, it is quite appropriate as the story revolves around the old man. The old man in the story is the symbol of all those who suffer the horrors of war. If you look at the title carefully, children, you will realize the author has used Old Man at the Bridge and not the old man. He hasn't used definite article the. He is not talking about one specific man, but old man. Old man here symbolizes all those who suffer the horrors of war. Next, the bridge in the story is much more than physical structure. The bridge is symbolic of life that connects the two ends, that is, birth and death. Perhaps the old man wants to cling to life and does not want to go to the other side. That is, his impending death. Death is imminent. Since the old man is at the bridge, he has two options: to cross over the other side and to go to Barcelona and live the rest of his life devoid of the company of his animals and birds, or to stay at home and share the fate of his animals and birds. Thus, the bridge symbolizes the points of no return for the old man. The bridge is also symbolic of the need to give up war, to talk to each other and connect with each other through the bridges of faith, trust, brotherhood and humanity. The old man is also a symbol of the defeat of liberal democracy in Spain. Now, moving on to the characters in the story. We have come across two main characters, that is the old man and the narrator. The old man is the protagonist, the main character of the story. He is not given any name. The old man has a high sense of duty as he believes that he must watch over the animals in San Carlos. He is unable to fulfill his responsibilities and hence guilty and struggles throughout the story. The next is the narrator. We all know who is narrating us the story. The unnamed narrator is a young soldier who narrates us the story in first person. He is a kind man who starts pitying for the old man's condition. He realizes the old man's deplorable condition and thus tries to give him hope, reassuring him throughout the story. Now, looking into the themes in the story, the pointlessness of war. One of the main themes is the pointlessness of war, that is how futile the war is. The Spanish Civil War of 1938 forms the background to the story, and Hemingway depicts how in times of war, man acts inhumanly to his own race. The most destructive of all explosives, which even machine cannot detect, is hatred, vengeance, loathing found in the human mind. If we don't eradicate our destructive emotions, there will be no end to war and violence. The culture and tradition passed on from generation to generation are uprooted and innocent people are killed without mercy. In the wake of war, all that is left is death, poverty and epidemic. These are the war gifts to humanity. Next theme is compassion. The theme of compassion is reflected through the nameless soldier. The soldier becomes a good friend in need for the old man with whom he shares his worries. The soldier feels sorry for him. He urges, coaxes the old man to get up and cross the bridge many a times, but he fails. Moving on to the setting of the story, we all know where the story is set. We have spoken about it. Hemingway has captured the true picture of war and its effects without a single shot being fired or a drop of blood spilled in this story of a nameless old man at a pontoon bridge. Let us look into the style of writing. The narration, the story is told by the young soldier in first person. It is basically a conversational style that has been used. Next is the irony. Irony means the manifestation of the double meaning, which is very persistent here. It implies of the opposite of what it normally means. In the last pair of the story, we come across irony, that is about Easter, which we have already discussed. The next style is symbolism. There are a lot of symbols used in the story. Hemingway uses the tip of iceberg principle, that is a visible sign of something invisible. The small tip of the iceberg on the surface of water is suggestive of its 7 times larger mass under the surface. The Ebro River is a symbol of man's life journey. Here, Ebro River pushes the old man towards a change, a new life, but the old man clinches to death. Next, the animals. The animals in the story also stands for different qualities. The pigeons represent peace and harmony, and they fly away from the war, is a reference to the refugees who flee from the war to safer zones. The cat, symbol of independence, does not need anyone to survive. The goat, used as a sacrificial animal, represents the old man like a goat, which is sacrificed, the old man's fate is sealed. The bridge is a symbol of, next we are talking about the bridge. The bridge is a symbol of uncertainty and danger. These are the feelings most of the people have during wartime. Next, the day. The day is described as gray overcast day, which is symbolic of old age, sadness and destruction. Moving on to the conflicts in the story, we come across two conflicts, that is internal as well as external conflicts. What is internal conflict? The conflict which is between the old man and his inner self. He is emotionally attached to his animals and struggles with his inner self as he feels guilty and has not done justice to the animals he was supposed to protect. Thus, crossing the bridge would have protected him physically but would not have given him psychological and inner peace. The next conflict is the external conflict, that is man against another man, the conflict between man against another man. In times of war, a man causes pain and suffering to another man. He fights with his own race for a seemingly greater good. Man's inhumanity to man forces the old man to leave his hometown. Now I think all of you have understood the story, children. Go through the story once again. And that's it, children. I will take leave now. Thank you.